Now, will COVID be the watershed moment when it comes to healthcare and the digital focus on the sector as well? We spoke with Dr. Devi Shetty of Narayana Health as well as Ashutosh Raghuvanshi of Fortis to get a better sense of things as they stand. Listen in to an excerpt of this panel.
The most important change we need to bring about is the way to increase the skilled manpower, especially medical specialists. Now, central government has dramatically opened up higher medical education in their recent regulation just about a few days ago by opening the National Board of Examination, which is like a larger university, to conduct the training program in virtually any hospital in the country with over 100 beds. Now, what is the implication? The implication is that Karnataka state alone, the government, over 170 government hospitals will now become postgraduate institutions, training thousands of young doctors as medical specialists. This will dramatically transform the way healthcare is delivered by having adequate number of specialists in all the public and private hospitals. But now the ball is in state government's court. If all the state governments start launching this course across the country, believe me, in 5 years' time, India will become the first country in the world to dissociate healthcare from affluence. We will make it happen.
Right. Dr. Raghuvanshi, the Prime Minister in the Independence Day speech emphasized on the medical system and how it needs to be changed and how there is going to be a unique identity on the lines of CIBIL or Aadhaar. How can this be implemented?
I think it is very important to have continuum of care. So if the system is fragmented, the primary care and the secondary and tertiary care are fragmented, then there is a lot of wastage which happens in the system. And in a